Hello everyone, Lich Dragon here, and I've got in front of me what is called a man crate. This was given to me by my wife for Father's Day, and I'm just now getting around to building it, because it is a knife making kit. It actually comes with tools and pretty much everything you need to make a knife. I've already kind of gone through and opened it a little. So we're gonna take everything out and we're gonna get started. I do many things. I consider myself a jack of all trades. Okay, so not only do I paint and draw and make random videos, I've also dabbled a tiny, tiny bit in blacksmithing. Some pictures to follow. But this is a pre-made knife, blank. I've, safety first, I covered it in a paper towel and some duct tape so that I don't cut my hand open when you doing that, so I'm gonna set that to the side. The kit comes with plenty of sandpaper, all the way from 100 to 600 grit, 220, 400, somewhere in there, for finishing the handle. Two wood pieces for the scales of the handle. It also comes with some brass hardware. Comes with these pins. I don't know if you can see that, but there's a pattern in there. These are for the scales, so they will fit in the knife in these larger holes here and be a beautiful adornment to the handle. Yes. It also comes with these smaller brass pins and these you know, I actually forgot the name of that. But this is supposed to go here. Above the handle. And then of course the wood scale goes down here. And you shape this to fit. It also comes with some very nice files for shaping the brass and the wood. Those are beautiful. And then, of course, the table vise we've already set up. So, oh, and a finishing touch, it comes with a beautiful leather sheath that we will soak in hot water and shape to the blade once we've finished. So that's for later. So, let's get started. For the record, I looked it up. This is called a bolster. This is the front bolster. Your knife can have a front bolster and a rear bolster, and then the handle can go in the center. So if the end of the knife here has a metal piece as well, that's the rear bolster. The piece goes up towards the blade is the front bolster. And then, of course, your handle is in the center. So, the more you know. So, apparently this wood is a lot harder than I realized. It's shaking the whole table as I'm trying to saw it. It's making everything fall off. Oh no. I may have to take this outside to my actual workbench. I'll be back. Okay, so, according to the quote-unquote instructions, the next step, after you've kind of roughed out the handle pieces, is to glue the pieces on with the epoxy that it comes with, like so, brass and all. And then drill the holes and then glue the other side on and drill the holes. But we're not gonna do that, are we? We don't follow instructions. We're gonna do it our way. Okay, so let me back up just a second to clarify. The reason we're not quite doing it the way the instructions have depicted is for this reason right here. These are the brass pins. Okay, these go in the holster that we talked about earlier. Okay, no problem. They fit right through. No big deal. Okay. We get one side to fit through, and what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to glue it in as far as you can, like so, and then fit the other side on after you've drilled the holes. Well, the problem is the way they've drilled their holes, this doesn't quite fit and line up with the other hole in the bolster slot. It's just not quite there. And I don't know if it's because of how it's burred, or perhaps the holes just don't quite align. Not entirely sure. So what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to line it up the best we can, clamp it on here with a vise, or in this case, some easy grips, and then do the best we can drilling the holes as we see fit without messing up the knife. Worst case scenario, I think I have some spare pieces of wood. Hopefully it doesn't come to that. So, off we go. Ah, this is not sponsored by NOS. Okay, so a little trial and tribulation, but we've got the holes. So, I will say, as a review, if you're listening out there, to these guys who make the whole knife thing, the drill bit that it comes with, not the best, but we made it work. And, you know, it's fine, but who needs instructions, right? So, got our holes. Next step is to line everything up, glue everything together, hope for the best, and then shape the handle. Shaping the handle is probably the most important part you're gonna do, because every knife will be individual to the person. You want it to fit your grip. And if you've noticed, if you've been paying attention, that does not fit. There's a huge error right here, but that's okay. You're supposed to make a gradient down to the blade, and it's supposed to mesh up with the brass. And then you make this rounded, maybe put some grooves in here for your fingers. There's supposed to be a lot of excess wood so that you can carve away at it and make it fit your hand. So, we're gonna get to it. We're gonna glue everything together and it'll be permanent, whatever the result. So, stay tuned. My goodness. I've never had so much trouble with even a pre-built knife. Like, this should not be this hard. The brass did not want to go all the way through. The pins did not want to go all the way through. After much mechanical persuasion, I managed to succeed. And now I've got it clamped. But in my haste to get it before the glue set, I've cracked the wood. However, it's okay because it didn't go past the brass. So when we do our sanding, you won't even notice this. It'll be gone. Poof. Out of existence. But we did manage to incur a slight gap. I don't know if you can see that, but there's a gap here. I guess it is just is what it is now, because there's no, like, fixing that. Not with the glue almost set. But, yeah. We're getting there. So we're gonna let this set, and then we'll come back to it, and we'll start shaping. Probably go straight to the belt sander? No. We're gonna hog off a lot of material first, then go to the belt sander. We'll be back. Okay, so it's been an hour or two since we let this set. It's pretty set now. Now the package does say like 8 to 12 hours to actually cure, but we can go ahead and start shaping it without worrying too much about it falling apart. So the idea here is we are going to remove a lot of this, round it off, remove some of the brassing, kind of shape it to the knife, probably round this off just a little, shape it down here nice and smooth, round this off, probably cut this at like a 45. Anyway, a lot of stock removal, so we're just going to get to it, get some time lapse going for you, and once we've done with the majority stock removal and kind of got the shape, general shape we want, I'm going to take it to the belt sander, and we're going to really shape it up that way and grind some of this flat. And then we've got the, obviously, the hand sand paper to finish up. So let's get to it. Actually, about 5 minutes of this and I'm already tired of it. So, to the belt sander and see if we can get the camera out there so you can see what's going on. Okay, so got the phone set up, got the belt sander. We're gonna turn this on and get to it, but first, can't forget safety. Got the dust mask. And now that I sound like Darth Vader, we're good to go. got the majority of the sanding done on the belt sander. So we've got a general shape for the handle. Fits nice. I got to do some fine tuning, so I guess we can go ahead and take it back inside and see if we can't take a little more off with some rasps, but fine tune it at the same time. So let's get to it. Everybody makes mistakes. And I guess it's a lesson in don't rush and don't use power tools when you don't need to. Let's see, where's the... Okay. Can you see that? That nice flat part where the blade should be. Yeah. Belt sander. But good news is the knife is still usable from here up. Just right there is a nice little nick. I guess I could sharpen this and make it a curved blade, but almost done. Just a few more polishing moves and we'll call it done. It's got some character. That's for sure. Okay, so we've pretty much been at this all day. I decided to take some resin and try to fill in a little bit of that hole there. So at least there's some structure to the wood, so it's not gonna crack on me any more than it already has. As well as, you know, you're not gonna feel that after I sand it smooth when you grip the knife. So far, so good. It feels good in your hand. It's nice and solid. Everything's relatively smooth other than that one hiccup, but that's okay. It still works and functions as a knife. So part two, we will finish up sanding and polish it up and call it a day. Till next time. So these are the blacksmithing knives that I made. They are made from old railroad spikes. Hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to like and subscribe.